Hello, I'm Kai from Enscape, and welcome to this new tutorial. In this video, I will show you how you can create a standalone export file. The benefits of an export file are that you can prepare and send them to your clients or use them for internal presentations. The receiver of this file doesn't need to have Revit or Enscape installed on his computer and is still able to explore your project in 3D. So, let's get started. I already have Revit 2016 open on my computer with the project file loaded. At the upper corner, you have your Enscape plugin installed. As you can see here, you can choose your required view. This is important because in the standalone export file, only the view that you choose here is visible. The user cannot choose another view in the export file. After you have decided which view you want, you can start Enscape. Now, you can see how nice your project looks in Enscape. To get an impression of it, I will fly inside the building and walk through it a little bit. By walking through your project, you can check once again if this is really the part of the model that you want to share with the export file. Before you create your export file, it is important that you adjust your settings the way you want them to be. Again, the user of the export file is not able to change the settings and is only able to see what you prepared for him. First, I will adjust the time of day and therefore the solar radiation in the project. By clicking and holding the right mouse button, you are able to change the time of day, and I want it to be early in the morning. Like this. This looks nice. Second, I will adjust some of the image settings available in Enscape. First, I want my contrast to be a little higher. Next, I want my image to be sharper. And I will adjust the shadow contrast. Like this. Now the project already looks more realistic and is ready for the export. To create your export, you only have to hit the export button here. In the next step, you can specify where your file has to be saved, and you can choose a name. I will call it example 1, hit save, yes, and we'll have to wait a few seconds. And as you see, our export was successfully created. To test this, I will go to my desktop and open the export file. But before I do that, I will close Enscape and Revit to show you that both programs are not necessary to open the export file. This is the file your colleague or client gets from you. As you can see, it looks just the same way as in Enscape via Revit. You can walk through the model or even fly through it and around it. This is a great tool to share your project with clients or colleagues, even if they don't have Revit or Enscape installed. As a last demonstration, I would like to show you a standalone export file created in Enscape as a paper model. I already prepared one file, this here. In this file, you can see how the export file as a paper model looks like. It is also a very nice tool to present your model in an early project phase. So, that's it for today. I hope this tutorial was helpful for you. Check out the standalones I generated in this video by clicking this button or look at the video descriptions. If you liked the video or have any questions, please feel free to send us some feedback via the feedback button in Enscape or contact us via email support@enscape3d.com. Thanks for watching. See you again next time.